زيارة الأربعين للإمام الحسين عليه السلام. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. السلام على ولي الله وحبيبه، السلام على خليل الله ونجيبه، السلام على صفي الله وابن صفيه، السلام على الحسين المظلوم الشهيد، السلام على أسير الكربات وقتيل العبرات. اللهم إني أشهد أنه وليك وابن وليك وصفيك وابن صفيك، الفائز بكرامتك، أكرمته بالشهادة وحبوته بالسعادة واجتبيته بطيب الولادة وجعلته سيدا من السادة وقائدا من القادة وذائدا من الذادة، وأعطيته مواريث الأنبياء وجعلته حجة على خلقك من الأوصياء، فأعذر في الدعاء ومنح النصح وبذل مهجته فيك ليستنقذ عبادك من الجهالة وحيرة الضلالة. وقد توازر عليه من غرته الدنيا وباع حظه بالأرذل الأدنى وشرى آخرته بالثمن الأوكس وتغطرس وتردى في هواه وأسخطك وأسخط نبيك وأطاع من عبادك أهل الشقاق والنفاق وحملة الأوزار المستوجبين النار، فجاهدهم فيك صابرا محتسبا حتى سفك في طاعتك دمه واستبيح حريمه. اللهم فلعنهم لعنا وبيلا وعذبهم عذابا أليما. السلام عليك يا ابن رسول الله، السلام عليك يا ابن سيد الأوصياء، أشهد أنك أمين الله وابن أمينه، عشت سعيدا ومضيت حميدا ومت فقيدا مظلوما شهيدا، وأشهد أن الله منجز ما وعدك ومهلك من خذلك ومعذب من قتلك، وأشهد أنك وفيت بعهد الله وجاهدت في سبيله حتى أتاك اليقين، فلعن الله من قتلك ولعن الله من ظلمك ولعن الله أمة سمعت بذلك فرضيت به. اللهم إني أشهدك أني ولي لما والاه وعدو لمن عاداه، بأبي أنت وأمي يا ابن رسول الله، أشهد أنك كنت نورا في الأصلاب الشامخة والأرحام المطهرة، لم تنجسك الجاهلية بأنجاسها ولم تلبسك المدلهماتي من ثيابها، وأشهد أنك من دعائم الدين وأركان المسلمين ومعقل المؤمنين، وأشهد أنك الإمام البر التقي الرضي الزكي الهادي المهدي، وأشهد أن الأئمة من ولدك كلمة التقوى وأعلام الهدى والعروة الوثقى والحجة على أهل الدنيا. وأشهد أني بكم مؤمن وبإيابكم موقن بشرائع ديني وخواتيم عملي، وقلبي لقلبكم سلم وأمري لأمركم متبع، ونصرتي لكم معدة حتى يأذن الله لكم. فمعكم معكم لا مع عدوكم، صلوات الله عليكم وعلى أرواحكم وأجسادكم وشاهدكم وغائبكم وظاهركم وباطنكم. آمين رب العالمين. وصل اللهم على محمد وآله الطاهرين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والحمد لله رب العالمين، بارئ الخلائق أجمعين، باعث الأنبياء والمرسلين، ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وسيد المرسلين، حبيب إله العالمين، المصطفى أبي القاسم محمد، الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين المنتجبين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا، الله صلى الله، ولعنة الله على أعدائهم أجمعين إلى قيام يوم الدين. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله، السلام عليك يا ابن رسول الله، السلام عليك يا غريب كربلاء. رزقنا الله في الدنيا زيارتكم وشفاعتكم في الدنيا والآخرة. أما بعد، فمما جاء في زيارة أمين الله: اللهم اجعل نفسي مطمئنة بقدرك، راضية بقضائك، مولعة بذكرك ودعائك، محبة لصفوة أوليائك، محبوبة في أرضك وسمائك، صابرة على نزول بلائك، شاكرة لفواضل نعمائك، ذاكرة لسوابغ آلائك، مشتاقة إلى فرحة لقائك، متزودة التقوى ليوم جزائك، مستنة بسنن أوليائك، مفارقة لأخلاق أعدائك، مشغولة عن الدنيا بحمدك وثنائك. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. This is the last lecture of this mini-series on the nafs, where on the first night we described some aspects of the nafs. The second night we spoke about the revival of the nafs. The third night we spoke of the purification of the nafs. And last night we spoke of the success of the mu'mineen, the believers, where we discussed the first 11 verses of Surah Al-Mu'minun and how we can implement these verses as practical means of purifying ourselves and getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tonight, insha'Allah, we will conclude our discussion, if Allah gives us tawfiq, with the ziyarah of Al-Imam Al-Husayn salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayh. The sentences we discussed just now, we started our discussion with, are from Ziyarat Aminillah. Ziyarat Aminillah is a ziyarah that Al-Imam Al-Sajjad salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayh taught us when he went to visit the qabr of Amir al-Mu'mineen salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayh. It is also recommended to be recited at the qabr and the shrine of all the ma'sumeen alayhim as-salam. It is one of those ziyarat that is known as a ziyarah al-jami'ah, the ziyarah that is applied to all the imams alayhim as-salam. So ziyarat Aminullah is a very important ziyarah. It is narrated, if you read the book Mafatihul Jinan, when he narrates ziyarat Aminullah, at the end of it, he says, when a mu'min recites this ziyarah, meaning ziyarat Aminullah, at the shrine of the ma'sumeen alayhim as-salam, it is placed on a plate of nur, light, and presented to al-imam al-mahdi al-muntazar, sahib al-asri wa al-zaman, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi. So it's a very important ziyarah. It's a very important visitation. In that ziyarah come these statements of dua about the nafs. So one good way, my brothers and sisters, to really purify ourselves is reading this dua. Try to memorize it or write it down and read it on a regular basis. This dua purifies. It starts by saying, Allahumma ij'al nafsi, or Allah, make my nafs mutma'inna, tranquil. Yani, grant me the ability to control my evil commanding self such that I can ascend to reach the status of an-nafsul mutma'inna. And we read in the Quran, Ya ayyatuha an-nafsul mutma'inna, irji'i ila rabbiki radiyatan mardiyah. An-nafs al-mutma'inna is a very high caliber, very high nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says he takes, or basically the angels would take, malaika sometimes, or he, Allah yatawaffa al-anfus, he takes the nafs. But when it comes, when a person reaches the nafs al-mutma'inna, the tranquil self, Allah says to it, return back. So it's not going to take it. When the death of a mu'min who has achieved the status of an-nafsul mutma'inna, when the time of his death or her death comes, Allah will tell the nafs, return back. Yani, not take it, rather he will ask it, he will tell it, return back, irji'i. And we read a hadith on the eve of Ashura this year. The eve of Ashura, you can go back to that lecture. I'm not going to repeat it again, but there is a hadith from Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam where he says, "An-nafs al-mutma'inna is nafs al-Imam al-Husayn salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi." Now, that is the specific meaning of the ayah. As I mentioned in the past, some of the verses in the Quran have a general meaning, and sometimes they have a specific meaning, a ta'wil or a hidden meaning. The hidden meaning of the ayah is the nafs of Imam al-Husayn salamullahi alayhi. But here in this dua of Aminullah, Ziyarat Aminullah, we pray to Allah, Allahumma ij'al nafsi mutma'innatan biqadarik, mutma'inna biqadarik, with whatever you decree upon it. Yani, whatever you decide for me, Ya Allah, make me pleased with this. That does not mean we should not strive to become better people and to enhance our lives and progress in life, but whatever we are left with, whatever we get in our way after striving and working hard, we should be pleased with this. And in fact, there is a hadith from Al-Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, where he says, أَعْوَنُ شَيْءٍ عَلَى صَلَاحِ النَّفْسِ الْقَنَاعَةِ. The biggest aid for the perfection of the nafs, of the self, is contentment, qana'a. You be content with what you have. So here the dua says, Allahumma ij'al nafsi mutma'innatan biqadarik. Content does not mean that I don't strive, I don't work hard, I don't study hard, I don't have ambition, I don't have aspirations. Of course you do. But you'll leave the rest up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When He gives you something, He says, say Alhamdulillah. Okay? So that's something important. اجعل نفسي مطمئنة بقدرك راضية بقضائك. It is pleased with your command. What you command, I am pleased with it, Ya Allah. Just like Al-Imam Al-Hussein salamullahi alayhi, many times on the day of Ashura, when his baby was killed, for example, one of those times when his baby was killed, he says, Allahumma ridhan biqadaik. Oh Allah, I am pleased with your command. Allahumma in kana hadha yurdhik, fakhud hatta tarwa. If this pleases you, then take from me until you are fully pleased. Allahumma ij'al nafsi mutma'innatan biqadarik, radiyatan biqadaik, mula'atan bidhikrika wa du'aik. It is, make it so eager with your remembrance, your dhikr, and your du'a. يعني we need to turn to Allah, always pray to Allah, do du'a to Allah. Indeed, du'a can purify yourself. If you ask Allah consistently to pray, to purify you. In fact, every day in the morning, after Salatul Fajr, brothers and sisters, spend at least 1 minute. Few seconds, even if it's not one, a few seconds. Talk to Al-Imam Al-Mahdi alayhi salam. Say, As-salamu alayka ya ibn Rasulillah. Say, ya ibn Rasulillah, I love you. I am one of your followers. And I would like to be among your companions. So help me. Help me to overcome any obstacle that would prevent me from being from amongst your companions. Talk to the Imam salamullahi alayhi. Speak to him. He hears you. He listens to you. And inshallah, he will pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he will help you to become among his companions, inshallah. Mula'atan bidhikrika wa du'a'ik. اللهم اجعل نفسي مطمئنة بقدرك راضية بقضائك مولعة بذكرك ودعائك محبة لصفوة أوليائك. It is loving to see the group of your أولياء. It loves to see your أولياء. صفوة أوليائك محبة لصفوة أوليائك to the end of this دعاء in زيارة أمين الله. So it is a very beautiful دعاء. And it is a great dua to read on a regular basis. The ulama of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam worked diligently to write books about the ziyarat of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. For example, Ibn Qawluwayh al-Qummi radwanullahi ta'ala alayh wrote a book called Kamilus Ziyarat. He is the teacher of al-Sheikh al-Mufid. He died in the year 368. الشيخ المفيد wrote a book called Al-Mazar. He died in the year 413 after Hijrah. الشيخ الطوسي, the student of الشيخ المفيد and الشريف المرتضى. He died in the year 460 after Hijrah. He wrote the book مصباح المتهجد. So several of the ulama have written books about the ziyarat of Ahlul Bayt. And Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam emphasized on the ziyarat. These ziyarat can contain some great content about the merits of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. The merits of Ahlul Bayt. So read them, try to learn about them, try to reflect upon them. One of the greatest ziyarat is ziyara al-jami'a al-kabira. Al-ziyara al-jami'a al-kabira. This ziyara is narrated by those great ulama in Kamil al-Ziyarat by Ibn Qawluwayh al-Qummi and the father of al-Shaykh al-Majlisi, Allam al-Majlisi, the author of Mufatih al-Jinan. His name was Muhammad Baqir. His father, Muhammad Taqi al-Majlisi. His father, he was a alim. He says, whenever I go to the ziyarat of the Ma'sumin, I read ziyara al-Jami'a al-Kabira. And all of our ulama, all of our ulama, even contemporary ones, they attest to the authenticity of Ziyara al-Jami'a al-Kabira. Now, some people try to claim that it is not authentic because of its sanad, because of the narrators, the chain of narrators. But even if, we say, hypothetically speaking, although that is not true, but even if the chain of narrators may not be so strong, the content of Ziyar al-Jami' al-Kabira is all valid and accepted by all our ulama. All our ulama. So people should not start to come out and say, no, this ziyarah is weak, that ziyarah, whatever, and so on and so forth. And when it comes to ziyarah of Al-Imam Al-Husayn alayhi salam, Ahlul Bayt gave a lot of emphasis on the ziyarah of Al-Imam Al-Husayn salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi. Generally speaking, for example, I'll read you this hadith from Bihar al-Anwar, al-Allama al-Majlisi narrates from Al-Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam. He says, مروا شيعتنا بزيارة قبر الحسين. Order our Shia to visit the grave of Al-Husayn alayhi salam. فإن إتيانه, for surely coming to him, يزيد في الرزق, it will increase your sustenance. ويمد في العمر, and it will increase your age, your life. ويدفع مدافع السوء, and it will keep harm away from you. وَإِتْيَانَهُ مُفْتَرَضٌ وَإِتْيَانُهُ مُفْتَرَضٌ, and coming to him is obligatory. على كل مؤمن يقر للحسين بالإمامة من الله. It is an obligation on every mu'min who confesses of his imama to Imam al-Husayn's imama before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you see, in general, Ahlul Bayt really emphasize. Now, when he says obligated, of course, those who are capable, those who have the ability, it's highly recommended, strongly, strongly recommended to visit the qabr of Al-Imam al-Husayn salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi. In some of the ahadith, the ziyarah of Al-Imam al-Husayn salamullahi alayhi is equivalent, is given the equivalence of 20 hajjs and 20 umrah. 20 hajjs and 20 umrah. And sometimes even more, even more. So here a person sometimes asks and says, how is the ziyarah of Imam al-Husayn more equivalent, more rewarding than a hajj? Yani instead of me going to hajj, should I just go to the qabr of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam? We say, hajj is wajib. And when you have the ability to go to hajj and you have not performed hajj before, then you need to go to and perform your hajj because it is wajib. So hajj is wajib. One should not use the excuse that the ziyarah of Imam al-Husayn is more rewarding than hajj, and therefore I'm going to go to Imam al-Husayn instead of going to hajj. So that is not a valid excuse. Hajj is wajib. You have to perform your hajj. Having said this, sometimes not every wajib is more rewarding than an action that is mustahab. What do we mean by this? Saying the salam, and saying assalamu alaykum, is not wajib. Answering the salam is wajib. Even if someone were praying in the salat, you are in the salat and somebody walks into the room, doesn't realize that you're praying and says assalamu alaykum so and so. If you're in the middle of your salah, such like, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, you need to reply back with the same sentence he said to you. So if he says, Salamun Alaikum, you also say, Salamun Alaikum. And then you continue with your salat. The person who says salam, it's mustahab. Answering the salam is wajib. Yet, the hadith says, the one who initiates the salam gets 69 the ajr. Whereas the one who answers the salam gets one. Yani the one who initiates the salam, which is mustahab, gets many, many folds the ajr of the one who answers the salam, which is wajib. So therefore, not every time an action which is wajib may have the same action or the reward as an action which is mustahab. And this would answer this issue. So my brothers and sisters, ziyarah of Al-Imam Al-Husayn is highly recommended. Ahlul Bayt encourage their Shia to visit Al-Imam Al-Husayn salamullahi alayhi on a regular basis. Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam asked one of the mu'mineen, he said to him, do you go to visit al-Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam every day, every week? He said, no, Ibn Rasulullah, I live far away. It is difficult for me to go to visit him every day or every week. He says, go from your house. From your house? He says, go to the satḥ, the roof of the house. Now, some houses don't have roofs. So maybe going to the last floor, the higher floor. And he says, look once to your right, to the left, and up, and say, As-salamu alayka ya Aba Abdullah. And he says, that will be considered as a ziyara for you, inshaAllah. One of the ziyarat of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. So going to Imam al-Husayn, going to the ziyara of Imam al-Husayn is highly recommended at any time of the year. All the time it is highly recommended to go for the ziyara of al-Imam al-Husayn salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi. It is highly recommended. And in fact, there is a hadith that says, من أراد أن يكون في جوار نبيه صلى الله عليه وآله وجوار علي وفاطمة فلا يدع زيارة الحسين عليه السلام. Whomever wants to be next to his prophet صلى الله عليه وآله and next to Ali and Fatima, let him not let go of the زيارة of Imam al-Husayn عليه السلام. In another hadith, Imam al-Sadiq عليه السلام, من سره أن يكون على موائد النور يوم القيامة فليكن من زوار الحسين بن علي عليه السلام. Anyone who is pleased to become among the people who sit on the tables of light, نور, tables made of نور, light. Subhanallah, in dunya, light is not something that you can build something from. You cannot build a table from light itself. But in the akhirah, a table is built from light. If you want to sit on such tables on the Day of Judgment, then become among the Zuwar of Al-Imam Al-Husayn alayhi salam. So these ahadith are numerous for the ziyar of Imam Al-Husayn salamullah alayhi. Now some people say, well, why Al-Imam Al-Husayn? How come Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi? We say, well, the response is very easy, brothers and sisters. There is also mustahab to do ziyar of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. We go to the ziyar of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Every time we go to Hajj, the mu'mineen are recommended to go to Medina and visit Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, visit the Imam Zinbaqi alayhim as-salam. So we also emphasize the ziyarah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. When it comes to Al-Imam al-Husayn, visiting Imam al-Husayn is visiting Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi himself says, Husaynun minni wa ana min Husayn. Husayn is of me and I am of Husayn. In addition, when someone goes to the ziyarah of Imam al-Husayn, he is doing the mawadda as per the command of Rasulullah in the Quran. قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا إِلَّا الْمَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَ. I don't ask you for a reward, but to show your love to my qurba, to my kin. So in me going to Al-Imam Al-Husayn, I am demonstrating this love to us Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. I'm showing him, Ya Rasulullah, I love him. And that's why I'm coming to visit him. Third, when I come to visit Al-Imam Al-Husayn, I learn from his sacrifice. I learn from the revolution. I hear his voice calling me, Hayhat minna dhillah. We refuse to live in humiliation. I hear him calling. I see death as nothing but happiness and living in humiliation and living with the tyrants. Wala inni ara al mauta, inni la ara al mauta illa sa'ada wal hayat, and living مَعَ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا بَرَمَ, and living with the tyrants as nothing, as humiliation. I hear these calls of Al-Imam Al-Husayn. I remember these sacrifices, and hence I become motivated, encouraged to go on the path of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. A few years ago, I remember going to Karbala with some mu'mineen. At the end of the ziyarah, one of them, young man, a teenager, approaches me and says, Sheikh, I was inconsistent of my salat. I did not pray consistently, unfortunately. Some days yes, some days no. However, with the visit of Al-Imam Al-Husayn alayhi salam, I have changed. I feel that Al-Imam Al-Husayn sacrificed his life for the sake of Islam. How can I not pray salat? So I am now committed to praying salat every day on time. So going to Al-Imam Al-Husayn is a great value, brothers and sisters. Indeed, it really connects us to Rasulullah, to Ahlul Bayt. And that's why Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam emphasize the visitation of Imam Al-Husayn more than any other of the ma'sumeen, any other one of the ma'sumeen. Because that sacrifice of the Imam salamullah alayhi draws people. It gets people energized, motivated. It changes the people. That does not mean it is not important to visit the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi and Ahlul Bayt, of course, all of them. But Imam al-Hussein is unique. He sacrificed for the sake of Allah, so Allah blessed him. One of those important ziyarat is ziyaratul arba'een, the ziyarah on the day of the 40th. Here, it's important to note a couple of things. First of all, some people say ziyaratul arba'een, is it really a tradition? Or is it something that the Shia came up with afterwards? And we say, no, it is a tradition. There are ahadith from it, from Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. For the sake of brevity, we'll mention only two. First of all, in the book Mazar by al-Shaykh al-Mufid, the book of al-Mazar by al-Shaykh al-Mufid, Shaykh al-Mufid, he died in the year 413 after Hijrah. He narrates this hadith from al-Imam al-Askari alayhi salam. Imam al-Askari says, "Alamatul mu'mini khams." The signs of the believers are five. Praying 51 rak'ah in the day. That is 17 rak'ahat for the wajib salat and 34 for the mustahab salat. 2 rak'ah nafila before salatul fajr. 8 rak'ahat nafila before dhuhr. Another 8 before asr. So that's together now is 18. 4 rak'at after Salatul Maghrib, that's 22. 1 rak'ah from Julus, from sitting down after Salatul Isha, that's 23. And the 11 rak'at of Salatul Layl, that's 34. Plus the 17 rak'at of the mandatory prayers, Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. These become in total 51 rak'at. So Imam al-Askari alayhi salam says, Alamat al-mu'min khams. There are five signs of the believer. One is praying 51 rak'at in the day. Two, wa ziyaratul arba'een, and visiting on the day of arba'een. Three, wa attakhadtum bil yameen, wearing the ring on the right hand side. It is mustahab to wear the ring on the right hand side. If you wear rings on the right hand side, then it's okay to wear on the left. Otherwise, to wear a ring on the left hand without the right hand, it is makruh, unless it is for the sake of taqiyyah, which is a separate story altogether. Otherwise, wearing a ring only on the left hand without the right is makruh. But wearing on the right hand side is mustahab. If you wear on the right and then you wear on the left, that's fine. There is nothing wrong with that. So Imam al Askari alayhi salam says the third is takhattum bil yameen wa ta'fir al jabini bis sujood. So when you do sujood, you wipe your head there on the turbah. Or you prolong your sujood such that the signs of sujood start appearing on the forehead. That's the fourth. And the fifth, wal jahar bi bismillah ar rahman ar rahim. So when you start, when in the salat, when you pray salat, you say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim out loudly. Even in the Salat where you have to whisper, like in Dhuhr and Asr, even then when you start, you say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim and then Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen ar-Rahman ar-Rahim and so on and so forth. So these are among. Now when the Imam says Alamat, these five signs are the signs of the believer, it doesn't mean these are the only signs, but these are among the signs that a believer should exhibit. So one of them is Ziyaratul Arba'een. This is in Kitab al-Mazar by Shaykh al-Mufid. It's also narrated by al-Shaykh al-Tusi, radwanullahi ta'ala alayh, in his book Al-Tahdhib, as per Mafatih al-Jinan. Shaykh Abbas al-Qummi says, it is also narrated by al-Shaykh al-Tusi in his book Al-Tahdhib. All right? So this hadith is there. Now some people say the sanad, the tradition of this hadith is weak, but that's not true. Several ulama, several mujtahideen, I have spoken to some of them. They say, no, the sanad of this hadith is authentic. It is correct. It is an authentic hadith. One of them is Ayatollah Sayyid Hadi al-Mudarrisi. He says this hadith is sahih. Correct. Authentic. And on the website of Ayatollah Sayyid Sistani, Hafizahullah, may Allah prolong his life. There was a question that some people claim that there is no merit for the ziyarah of Arba'een. There is no ahadith about it. The reply was, such sayings should be ignored. Yani people who claim such claims, they should be ignored. La yu'ba. He says there is no, ignore these kind of sayings. Which means that ziyaratul Arba'een has tradition, has roots in the ahadith of Ahlul Bayt alayhimus salam. So that's one. A hadith from Imam al-Askari salamullah alayhi, where he says of the signs of the mu'min is ziyaratul Arba'een. That's one. The second, ziyarah of al-Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam on the day of Arba'een. On the day of Arba'een, there is a ziyarah of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. This is found in Misbahul Mutahajjid wa Silahul Mutaabbid by Sheikh al-Tusi. Sheikh al-Tusi died in the year 460 after Hijrah. He narrates the hadith, he narrates the ziyarah from Safwan ibn Mahran, from al-Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam. He says, في زيارة الأربعين تزور عند ارتفاع النهار. يعني when the sun rises, you do the ziyarah of al-Arba'een, of al-Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. And he gives the ziyarah, which is found today in the book of Mafatih al-Jinan. As-salamu ala waliyillah wa habibih, as-salamu ala khalilillahi wa najibih, and so on, so forth. Also in this book, مصباح المتهجد وسلاح المتعبد, he also mentions the hadith of al-Imam al-Askari alayhi salam. The signs of the believer are five. Alamatul mu'minin, khams. Salatul ihda wa khamsin, wa ziyaratul arba'in, wa attakhadtum bil yameen, wa ta'firul jabeen, wa al-jahru bi bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So you see, my brothers and sisters, our early ulama, Sheikh al-Mufid, who died in the year 413 after Hijrah, narrates this hadith of ziyaratul arba'in by al-Imam al-Askari alayhi salam. Al-Shaykh al-Tusi, who died in the year 460 after Hijrah, narrates this hadith in his book Misbah al-Mutahajjid. He also narrates the ziyarah of Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam to al-Imam al-Husayn on the day of Arba'een. So therefore, there is no doubt about the ziyarah of al-Imam al-Husayn salamullahi alayhi on the 40th or the 20th day of Safar, 40 days after his martyrdom salamullahi alayhi. And hence it's important, brothers and sisters, here just to make one thing clear. Some people start coming up these days and say, this ziyarah is not authentic, that ziyarah is not authentic. That is, as the response from the office of Ayatollah Sistani says, ignore these kind of sayings. Some people these days are also doubting ziyarat Ashura. Even ziyarat Ashura, with all its authenticity and its merits, people are saying this ziyarah also is not authentic. And they give up various reasons. I am not here to discuss ziyarat Ashura. Maybe this is for a later time, another discussion, inshallah. All I'm going to tell you is that ziyarat Ashura is authentic with the 100 la'an and the 100 salam. And not a single marja' al-taqleed that we have living amongst us today who doubts that the ziyaratul Ashura, ziyarat Ashura, is not authentic. Not a single one of them. Yani none of them says the whole ziyarah, just ignore it. That's nonsense. So people who come up with these claims, unfortunately, they don't realize the value of these ziyarat. And they may bring some excuses. Again, I'm not here to discuss ziyarat Ashura specifically, but they talk about the la'an and they talk about some other things. The la'an is mentioned in the Quran. Allah says those people, yal'anhumullah wa yal'anuhumul la'inun. People who disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are cursed by Allah and by the people who curse them as well, la'inun. So there are those who curse as well, do la'an. In numerous occasions in the Quran, Allah refers to the la'an. He does la'an of individuals, of certain individuals, of certain groups. Those who hurt Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi, and so on and so forth. So why is it all of the sudden now when it comes to the la'an of the murderers of al-Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, we say no, that should not be the case. Doesn't Allah say that those who hurt Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi are cursed? So those who killed Al-Imam Al-Hussein, you think they did not hurt Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi? The Prophet cried for Al-Imam Al-Hussein salamullah alayhi. Look at the ahadith. Not only us, referred to a book called Ibn Hajar al-Haytami. Ibn Hajar al-Haytami, al-Sawa'iq al-Muhriqah. Al-Sawa'iq al-Muhriqah fil-raddi ala ahli al-bid'i wal-zandaqa by Ibn Hajar al-Haytami. This man has written a book against the Shia. He calls them the people of the innovation. And zandaqa, wal-iyadu billah, people of non-religion, yani people of disbelief. In his book, referred to the section about Al-Imam Al-Hussein, he says, hadith from Umm Salama. Umm Salama says, I went to see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. One day I saw him crying deeply. I said, what's the matter, ya Rasulullah? He says, Jibra'il came to me and he told me that my son Hussein, who was with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi at the time, will be killed by a group of people who claim to be of my ummah. So the Prophet was crying and he says, he brought me some of the sand of Karbala. She says, he gave me the sand. And he said, keep it with you, ya Umm Salama. The day you see it turning red, be aware that my son Hussein has been killed. And indeed, she said, I kept that jar, the qarura. When one day I woke up, I saw it turned red, I realized al-Hussein was killed in Karbala. Salamullah alayhi. This is narrated by Ibn Hajar al-Haytami, not the Shia, in his book, Al-Sawa'iq al-Muhriqah. So the Prophet was hurt. Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullah alayhi was hurt. Fatima al-Zahra was crying for al-Imam al-Hussein. So we don't cry. My brothers and sisters, one of the ways if we want to purify ourselves, we need to increase our connection to al-Imam al-Hussein salamullah alayhi. In Ziyarat Ashura, in Ziyarat al-Arba'een, one of the sentences it states, وَبَذَلَ مُهْجَتَهُ فِيكَ. And he sacrifice, he gave up his life in you, يعني in your love, ya Allah, for you. Why? لِيُنْقِذَ عِبَادَكَ, to save your servants, to save them. مِنَ الْجَهَالَةِ, from ignorance. وَحَيْرَةِ الظَّلَالَةِ, and the confusion of misguidance. To save us from ignorance and the confusion of misguidance. Meaning, if we follow the path of Al-Imam Al-Hussein, we read about him, we listen about his lectures, we read about his values and what he stood for, we go to visit him, we cry for him, we attend his majalis, we serve his majalis. The more we give to Al-Imam Al-Hussein, salamullahi alayhi, the more connection we have to Al-Imam Al-Hussein, salamullahi alayhi, the more we'll be on the sirat al-mustaqim, the more away we will be from the path of confusion, wal-iyadu billah, and misguidance and ignorance. So my brothers and sisters, hold on to Al-Imam Al-Hussein, salamullahi alayhi. Always attend his majalis. Now these days, because of the pandemic, listen to his majalis. Read about Al-Imam Al-Hussein. Try to serve. Serve in the cause of Imam Al-Hussein. Any way you think about, how can you serve? Do so. Always stay affiliated with Al-Imam Al-Hussein. Believe me, it protects your nafs, it protects your faith, it protects your religion. Go to the ziyarah of Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam, inshallah, once this pandemic is over and people can travel and go attend. This year, unfortunately, people were not given visas to go for the ziyarah. So some of them may not have had the opportunity. But inshallah, once this pandemic is over, with the barakah of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam, everyone inshallah stay safe. Once this is over, go to the ziyarah of Imam al-Hussein, salamullahi alayhi. Don't let go of the ziyarah of Imam al-Hussein. And especially ziyaratul arba'een. Now millions of people go to the ziyarah. Subhanallah, ziyaratul arba'een has become something unique. Something unique. On the 40th of Imam al-Hussein, one of the mu'mineen I traveled with to arba'een a few years ago, he says, I've traveled across the globe. He's an elderly man. He is maybe in his late 70s, early 80s. He says, I have never seen anything like this, where people serve you for the sake of Allah. They massage your feet, they give you food, they do anything that you require to stay comfortable while visiting Al-Imam Al-Hussein, salamullahi alayhi. One of the ladies who was a revert to Islam, She experienced difficulties, unfortunately, after she converted to Islam or reverted to Islam, especially with some of the people who claim to be among the followers of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. They unfortunately took advantage. This lady, she told me, she said, I had the opportunity to visit Al-Imam Al-Husayn salamullahi alayhi. Upon visiting him, when I entered into that shrine, I felt the power. I felt that tranquility. I felt that affinity. I felt the love. And I said, indeed, he is a man whom I'm proud to follow as my imam. He's my imam. I'm proud to follow him as my imam. And she said, if it weren't for that visit of mine to Al-Imam Al-Husayn in Karbala, I may not have remained as a Muslim, as a Muslima, because of what I saw from some of the people. But I realized these people do not represent the values of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. So Imam Al-Husayn salamullahi alayhi indeed is a guide. He guides us. Brothers and sisters, try to read Ziyarat Aminullah and read the dua, Allahumma ij'al nafsi mutma'innatan biqadarik, radiyatan biqada'ik, mula'atan bidhikrika wa du'a'ik, and so on, so forth to the end of this dua. Write it down and read it in your qunut, in the salat, one of the salats, for example. Or read it after the salat, after some of your salat, this dua. Every day after Salatul Fajr, talk to Al-Imam Al-Mahdi alayhi salam, even if it's for a few seconds. Say, As-salamu alayka ibn Rasulillah. I would like to be among your Shia, so help me and guide me to become among your Shia and your followers, inshallah, and your companions. Speak to him, inshallah, he will provide you with this guidance. Third, try to affiliate yourself with Al-Imam Al-Husayn salamullah alayhi as much as you can. Listen to the majalis of Al-Imam Al-Husayn. Listen to the dhikr of Al-Imam Al-Husayn. Serve in the name of Al-Imam Al-Husayn salamullahi alayhi. Participate in the aza. You hold majalis in your houses. Inshallah, this will bring a lot of barakah and a lot of blessings for you. Even if every day you read two lines, two verses of poetry for Al-Imam Al-Husayn salamullahi alayhi. Every day in your house, you yourself, after Salatul Fajr, you don't know anything, just open up a book of poetry for Imam Al-Husayn and read a couple of verses. Or download something from the internet and read a couple of verses. They bring a lot of barakat for you. And truly, this will bring a lot of blessings for you. Try to visit Al-Imam Al-Husayn. Read Ziyarat Ashura every day. If you can, Ziyarat Ashura, try to read it every day with the 100 la'an and the 100 salam. And then you do the sujood. After you read that short paragraph after the 100 salam, read to the sujood, then pray to rak'at salat and read dua al-qama. And then ask for your hajah. Insha'Allah, it will be answered. And if you do this for 40 consecutive days with the niyyah of a specific hajah, a specific need, it might take you about an hour, 45 minutes to an hour to finish all this on a daily basis. But you will see the reward and the great ajr. I remember one of the people asked one day, Ayatollah Bahjat, who died a few years ago, not too long ago. He asked him, he said, some people doubt the authenticity of Ziyarat Ashura. He said to him, after all the merits people we've seen from Ziyarat Ashura, people still have doubts about Ziyarat Ashura. So read Ziyarat Ashura every day, to the best of your ability, if not once in a week, with the 100 la'an and the 100 salam. Try to say at least once in your week, if not every day, As-salamu alayka ya Aba Abdullah al-Husayn. And we are now at the time of Ziyaratul Arba'een. Some of us did not get the tawfiq to go to Karbala, but our hearts are in Karbala. So associate yourself with the love of Imam al-Husayn. Shed your tears for Al-Imam al-Husayn. And as you shed your tears, try to pray to Allah to give us the best of akhlaq, the best of manners, to make us among people whom Al-Imam Al-Husayn would be proud of. Inshallah, Allah makes us and our progeny until the Day of Judgment among the Shia of Imam Al-Husayn and the servants of Al-Imam Al-Husayn, and grants us the Shafa'ah of Al-Imam Al-Husayn salamullahi alayhi, and resurrects us on the Day of Judgment with Al-Imam Al-Husayn alayhi salam, and keeps us on the ranks of Al-Imam Al-Husayn salamullahi alayhi. On this day, the 40th,
جابر بن عبد الله الأنصاري, the companion of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وآله, comes with a companion by the name of Atiyyah to visit Al-Imam Al-Hussein سلام الله عليه. He tells Atiyyah, take me to the river of Furat. He goes to the river of Furat. He washes, he takes a shower, a wash, and then he comes out, he wears new clothes. Then he tells Atiyyah, do you have some perfume on you? He says, yes. So he gives him some perfume, he perfumes himself. Then he takes short steps, towards the qabr of Al-Imam Al-Hussein, salamullahi alayhi. He goes towards the qabr of As-Sayyid al-Shuhada. As they arrive, they see few graves. Atiyyah says, I don't know which of these is the grave of Imam Al-Hussein, salamullahi alayhi. By that time, Jabir has lost his eyesight. So he tells Atiyyah, he says, take me to the qubur, to those graves. I will tell you which is the grave of Abi Abdullah. He takes him to one qabur. He picks up some of the sand and smells it. He says, no, not this one. Take me to the other one. Until he takes him to one of the qubur, one of the graves. He picks up some of the sand. He smells it. And then he throws himself on the qabr of the imam. He says, As-salamu alayka ya Abu Abdullah. Salamun alayka ya Sayyidi ibn Rasulullah. And he starts calling him, Hussein, Hussein. حبيبٌ لا يجيب حبيب وأنا لك بالجوائب وقد فصل رأسك عن جسدك. He says, Hussein, this is your beloved Jabir and I love you. Answer me. Answer your lover, Sayyidi. But how can you respond when your head has been separated from your body? I bear witness, ashhadu, I bear witness that we were with you and we fought with you and we are with you. Atiyyah says, Jabir, what are you saying? How are we with him? These people who fought with Al-Imam Al-Hussein, they defended, they were shot with arrows, with spears, their hands were cut off, their heads were separated from their bodies. We didn't experience any of this. So how can you be saying this? He said, I heard my beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Anyone who loves the action of a group of people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will associate him with their action and will resurrect him with them. And I bear witness that I agree. And I am in agreement with what Abi Abdullah stood for and with what he was martyred for. يعني يا مؤمنين, here is the good news that you hear from Jabir, from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. You, for loving Abi Abdullah, for shedding your tears for Al-Imam Al-Hussein, inshallah, you will be among the companions of Al-Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam. May Allah make us among their companions, inshallah. May Allah give us the tawfiq to have the spirit and the value and the manners of Abi Abdullah Al-Hussein so that we are joined with him, inshallah. From this night, ask Allah, do not procrastinate, do not delay. From this night, say, Ya Rabbi, waffiqni, give me the tawfiq, the success to be among the Shia of Imam Al-Hussein, Ya Rabbi. Help me change to become a better person, to join Abi Abdullah Al-Hussein, alayhi salam. As they were doing the ziyarah, Atiyyah says, Ya Jabir, I see a group coming from far away. I can't tell who they are. Maybe some of them, maybe they are the guards of Ubaidillah ibn Ziyad, the spies of Ubaidillah ibn Ziyad. They're trying to see who visits Al-Imam Al-Hussein, so they would arrest him. Maybe we should go and hide. So they go and hide behind a palm tree, and Jabir says, you go, Atiyyah, and find out, investigate who these people are. This could be the family of Al-Imam Al-Hussein, salamullahi alayhi. Atiyyah goes, and then he runs back. He runs back to Jabir. He says, Ya Jabir, get up. This is your master, Zainul Abideen, Ali ibn al-Hussein. He's come back with the women and the children of Abi Abdullah al-Hussein. He says, take my hands to him. He takes his hands.
The minute he arrives at the camel of Al-Imam al-Sajjad, he throws himself on the feet of the Imam and says, As-salamu alayka ya ibn Rasulillah. He says, who's this? Is this Jabir? He says, Fadaka Jabir ya Sayyidi. He says, may Jabir be sacrificed for you. He says, tell me what happened in Karbala. Imam al-Sajjad replied, he said, Ya Jabir, Huna dhubihat rijaluna. Here our men were martyred, were slaughtered. Huna subiyat nisa'una. This is where our women were taken as prisoners. يا جابر شسولف لك عن يا ألم يا لوعة عن والدي الصاب السم وداسة الخيل ضلوعة ولو عن شفيل العائلة وشفينا المقطوعة ولو عن رباب الفاجدة ولو زينب المفجوعة. جابر, where shall I begin? Who shall I talk about? Shall I start with my father, Abi Abdullah al-Husayn? He fell under the horses of Bani Umayyah. And this is his head with me, Ya Jabir. I brought it back to bury it with the body. Or shall I tell you about my uncle Al-Abbas and his arm and hand that were cut off? Or shall I tell you about my brother Ali Al-Akbar? Or shall I tell you about Abdullah Ali Al-Asghar and the arrow in his neck? Or shall I tell you about the companions of Imam Al-Husayn? Or shall I tell you about the women and the children being taken as prisoners from Karbala to Kufa, Kufa to Sham? أيوة حسينا أيوة إماما. Then the women, the children, the family came back. This is now the first time they come back after they left. When they left, all the bodies were lying there on the plains of Karbala, covered with the arrows and the spears and their blood. Now they are in the qabr. Imam al-Sajjad had buried them, salamullahi alayhi. They came back, and every person, every lady threw herself from the camel onto the qabr. One is crying, oh my son. The other one's crying, oh my brother. The other one's crying, oh my father. This one is crying, oh my master. And they're all crying and weeping. Aywa Husayna, aywa Mama. Zainab also came to the qabr of Imam al-Husayn. خويا جيتك وجبت الراس وياي والله طول الدرب كانت بيه سلواي. Oh Hussein, I've come back. I brought your head back with me, Abu Abdullah. This whole journey, I was looking at your head, seeing your head, and I saw how the enemies of Allah beat your head in front of my eyes. Abu Abdullah, where shall I begin? Shall I tell you about my journey and what I endured? Shall I show you my body and how it's turned black from the whips of the enemies? Here the poets also describe another conversation. Zainab is apologizing to Abi Abdullah. Ya Zainab, why are you apologizing, Ya Zainab? Ya Aba Abdullah, you told me to take care of the women and the children, and I tried. But your daughter Ruqayya, I buried her in Sham. She died there, Ya Aba Abdullah. I could not bring her back to you. Then she stood up. Zainab, now where are you going? I'm going near the river of Furat to my brother Abbas.
I'm going to complain to him of what I saw in this journey, of the difficulties that we encountered. دست و علم کجا افتاده سقا کجا تشن جان داده یا ابو الفضل هي عباس. So she comes to the قبر of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas and starts weeping and crying, and the family spends time there in Karbala remembering the tragedies, the difficulties, until Imam al-Sajjad says, let's head back to Medina. So they start heading back to Medina. Upon arriving on the outskirts of Medina, Imam al-Sajjad finds a man by the name of Bishr ibn Hadlam. He says, Ya Bishr, your father used to recite poetry. Do you know any poetry? He said, yes, Ya Ibn Rasulullah, I do. He says, then go inside Medina and mourn the martyrdom of my father, Abi Abdullah. He went inside Medina and mourned, Ya Ahla Yathrib, La Muqama Lakum Biha, Qutil Al-Husayn, Fa'admu'i Midraru, Al-Jismu Minhu Bi Karbala, Amubarrajun, Wal-Ra'su Minhu Ala Al-Qanati Yudaru. Oh, people of Yathrib, get out of your homes and leave the city. Hussein has been killed in Karbala. His body is on the plains of Karbala while his head is on the spear going from one city to another city. The family goes back to the Medina. Zainab alayhi salam in pain goes to the qabr of Rasulullah, says, Ya Jaddah, Ya Rasulullah, جئتك ناعية ولدك الحسين قتل شهيدا مظلوما في كربلاء. Hussein was killed in Karbala. I'm bringing the news to you, Ya Rasulullah. Your beloved son was crushed under the horses of Bani Umayyah. His head was kept on the spears of Bani Umayyah. Ya Jaddah, Ya Rasulullah. روز ببینم داغ شما را یا مصطفی ای تاج سرم روز دگر دیدم بین آتش افتاده پشت در مادرم امروز روز ببینم در تشت پر خون پاره جگر از برادرم امروز عزایم در کربلا و حسین و عباس و اکبرم السلام على الحسين وعلى علي ابن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين وعلى أبي الفضل العباس ابن أمير المؤمنين السلام على الحوراء زينب وعلى شهداء كربلاء وعلى أم البنين ورحمة الله وبركاته إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون والعاقبة للمتقين. Raise your hands in the dua, brothers and sisters, on this holy night. Inshallah, du'as are accepted, hajat are fulfilled. May Allah grant us the ziyarah of Imam al-Hussein, or write our names among those who did the ziyarah of Imam al-Hussein on this day, inshallah, on this evening and on tomorrow, inshallah. Raise your hands in the dua. Many mu'mineen have asked us to remember them in their dua, in our dua. Some are suffering from illnesses, some are facing difficulties, and many have requested, and we all have hajat. May Allah grant us the shafa'ah of Imam al-Hussein, inshallah. Make us among the Shia of Imam al-Hussein, alayhi salam, Ya Rab. Us and our progeny until the day of judgment. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء
أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء اللهم إنا نسألك وندعوك باسمك العظيم الأعظم الأعز الأجل الأكرم 10 times together يا الله 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 إلهي بفاطمة وأبيها وبعلها وبنيها والسر المستودع فيها أكشف عنا السوء يا الله أو الله make us among the Shia of Imam al-Hussein عليه السلام يا رب العالمين us and our progeny until the day of judgment make us among the companions of صاحب العصر والزمان يا الله أو الله perfect our أخلاق and make us among those whom you are pleased with يا الله help us change ourselves to become among those whom you are pleased with and Ahlul Bayt are pleased with ya Allah make us among the sincere Shia of Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad ya Rabbil Alameen Allahumma qdi hawa'ij al-mu'minina wal-mu'minat shafi wa'afi jami'a marza al-mu'minina wal-mu'minat especially those who ask us to remember them in our dua fulfill their needs grant them a quick and complete recoveries from their illnesses those of them who are ill Grant them peace and security, those who are lacking peace and security in areas where there is not much peace and security. May Allah bless them with peace and security. The Zuwar of Imam al-Hussein, Ya Allah, protect them. Keep all harm away from them. Ya Allah, end this pandemic soon. And make us unite again on the remembrance of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. And keep all harm away from humanity at large. Oh Allah, forgive our parents. Bless our children. ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب. رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. اجزهما بالإحسان إحسانا وبالسيئات غفرانا. رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعاء. اللهم عجل لوليك الفرج واجعلنا من شيعته وأنصاره وأعوانه والمستشهدين بين يديه. اللهم كن لوليك الحجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه. في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين لقضاء الحوائج وشفاء المرضى وكشف هذه الغمة عن هذه الأمة ولتعجيل فرج مولانا صاحب العصر والزمان وإلى أرواح المؤمنين والمؤمنات والشهداء والعلماء especially for the أرواح of all your مرحومين brothers and sisters our dear viewers all those who participated in the execution of these majalis and for all the shuhada and the ulama رحم الله من يقرأ سورة المباركة الفاتحة مع الصلوات اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجهم I thank you very much brothers and sisters I hope you benefited from this series may Allah bless us inshallah to enhance ourselves inshallah please remember this insignificant servant of Al-Imam Al-Hussein عليه السلام in your dua May Allah bless you all. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.